Hello, this is Deanne from Small But Kind of Mighty. If you're interested in play-based learning, then take a look at these two videos and definitely stay tuned because I've got two huge freebies for you that you will definitely be interested in. Remember to subscribe to my channel, and if you don't want to miss the video that I publish every week, then hit the notification bell.
At Small But Kind of Mighty, I design and create toys and put together resources and materials to help parents and educators facilitate play-based learning for children of all ages and abilities. Amanda, who has the Backyard Buddies playset, said about it, "My kids love the bees and I love the little lavender plant she created. It comes with great stories I've read to my kids many times and they love it. Deanne is extremely talented and she found a way to make learning fun for my littles. Highly recommend." Later in the video, I've listed 8 activity ideas. But first, I wanted to put them into context by sharing with you my top 3 pillars for creating a virtuous circle of learning through play.
The key here is to have toys always available and to incorporate them into daily activities, not just play. So, for example, have them around when you're eating a meal or brushing teeth. Read stories out loud to your children every day for as long as they will let you. Watch people read books on YouTube. Listen to audiobooks in the car or maybe in the kitchen while you're cooking or baking together.
Now, this doesn't mean that you have to run out and spend a ton of money on books or an Audible subscription. In addition to the stories I write, in my resource materials, I review and recommend children's books which complement the themes of the playsets. All the books I recommend are available from my local public library. If your library is closed due to the pandemic, check if they utilize Libby or something similar so you can access ebooks and audiobooks. If not, Internet Archive is also an option.
I would love to hear from you. So comment below, do you read aloud to your kids? And if you do, how old are they? I'm really interested to know. This is where you bring everything together. Now, again, if you're not sure how to do this or you need ideas, don't worry, I've done all the work for you.
Both my play sets come with toys. Each toy has a story, and then the resource materials that also come with the playsets include a ton of reading recommendations together with play and activity ideas that pull everything together.
And stay tuned because the free resources that I mentioned earlier give you an idea of what these materials contain and how effective and useful they are.
Here are my 8 activity ideas that incorporate toys, stories, and opportunities for play. These not only reinforce each other, but lead to additional learning through play activities. Read Kitten's First Full Moon and make a moon nature journal. If you don't know how, check out this video on how to make a nature journal. Doing this gives you the opportunity to talk about the phases of the moon, tides, and some natural science. You could discuss nocturnal versus diurnal animals and make some butterflies and moths. Read Moon, Earth's Best Friend, then make some homemade kinetic sand and discuss the fact that there's no atmosphere on the moon and why this leads to more impact craters. Put together a really simple moon landing activity with a tub, some appropriate toys, and some dried black beans. Here's one that we did.
See is this. Oh, cool.
It's the space radar.
It's like a radio telescope.
And do you know who Katherine Johnson was?
Who's Katherine Johnson?
After our simple moon landing activity, we read Counting on Katherine. Not only is this book terrific for giving kids historical and biographical information, but it's a terrific way to start a conversation about gender and racial discrimination. We also talked about the incredible amount of stress that Katherine and the Apollo 13 astronauts must have been under, which brought us back to Luna's stories dealing with stress and overwhelm, and also making Mundo, which is cooling, calming, and therapeutic to play with.
What did you find? Ooh, you found. And look, it's like Buzz. Look, it's an astronaut with a jetpack. And what does Buzz do? He goes.
Owen is a huge Buzz Lightyear fan, and as a space ranger, he would presumably have no problem with jetting off to Saturn and Uranus. The Saturn sensory bin is oobleck, and the Uranus sensory bin is frozen oobleck. William Herschel discovered Uranus, and his sister Caroline was an important astronomer in her own right. Caroline's comets is her story.
You got the space shuttle. You got the goodies.
Got the space shuttle. Okay, guys, I think it's time for us to do a launch. So, Oliver, do you want the Saturn rocket or the space shuttle?
I'll have the Saturn rocket.
Okay, Mommy's going to have the space shuttle. Owen can have Robbie. Okay, guys, you ready?
10, 9, 8.
Robbie the Rocket is who Owen is launching, and Robbie had a role in Owen's Buzz Lightyear costume for Halloween a couple of years ago. One of the books that we've read about spaceships and rockets is called Spaceships and Rockets. And one of the things that I'm tempted to do with Owen is to make a bottle rocket. Check out this video for how to make one with Alka-Seltzer. The free Nature Journaling for Kids digital handout forms part of the materials that support the Backyard Buddies playset. The link in the description box below takes you directly to the page where you can add this handout to your cart. The free Planetary Sensory Walk handout includes 8 recipes for sensory playbin contents, including homemade kinetic sand, cloud dough, and oobleck, plus a bonus Mundo recipe. The link in the description box below will take you straight to the page where you can add this handout to your cart, and then you can proceed to check out. If the contents of your cart are all free, then you won't have to pay anything. If you're enjoying my play-based learning videos, then please give this one a like, subscribe to my channel, and share the videos with your friends. Thank you so much for watching, and speak with you soon.